Good morning, champions. I hope that you're doing very well after another great day of trading yesterday. We are here for another 5-minute morning trading update where I give you all of the information you need to trade successfully in the day ahead. I had a great comment from a member yesterday saying that they felt as if I was the sports team captain giving them their speech before the big must-win game. And that is exactly what it feels like for me. I feel as if I'm your captain of these charts and I'm here to guide you and give you the levels that I am trading off of as we absolutely crush the charts once again. Let's go. So, as you know, I'm going to be going over the four biggest markets in the world. Yesterday, I went over those, and today we are going to continue, starting with the DXY. I must say, before I begin, four biggest markets in the world, I correctly predicted all four of these markets. Also, well, starting with the DXY, as you know, we were looking for DXY strength yesterday, the dollar index. We will end with Bitcoin. Starting with the dollar index, as we know, this is our long-term time frame downtrend channel that we have been trading from. From breaking out of that channel, we back-tested also perfectly before another rise to the upside. DXY right now, massive resistance point. This is a level that is going to be heavily defended by the bears. Okay, we are sitting at around 94.25/94.50 resistance points. Okay, and for me, this is a big resistance, and I'm going to be explaining why as we reach gold in a second. So, important support obviously still remains the back test of this channel, which is coming at around 93.50 points. The reason why I say this is such a big resistance, because it is the last major resistance level before a potential rise all the way back up to yearly open. And that is simply because of the lack of resistance that was formed when we fell down so quick on the DXY. If we can actually reclaim this 94.50, there is a big potential of a very big rise to the upside and a pretty swift one at that. I'm not expecting that today, and that is because of my GC gold analysis, as I will get to in a second. Well, let's just go straight to it. So why am I expecting dollar weakness? And that is because, as predicted yesterday, the gold futures were obviously looking weak. And we were saying, you know, it was likely that we were going to come down in the end and test this weekly. And Lou, would you look at this? One of the biggest markets in the world, respecting technical analysis to the T. As we can see here, getting that confluence once again off the middle of the channel onto your weekly level and a very strong bounce off of the weekly. Okay, it's not out of the woods yet, though, for the bulls. Absolutely not, because of the fact, yes, we've bounced off the weekly, but the market structure remains bearish. Indeed, what I would like to see is really a reclaim of 1920. And that would be a good sign that we can go back up and test those levels around 1960. So there's a lot of work to be done here for the bulls, but it's starting well this morning. Okay, the nice reaction off the weekly. What I would say is if we lose that weekly, then it's very likely indeed that we come down and test the monthly level on gold. I would expect more of a fight to be put up than just falling straight back down, if I'm totally honest with you. But, you know, this is just part of the game, really. I think you've got a crucial support here. If you lose that crucial support, you've got a big drop down to that next support level, which is the monthly. You regain 1920, go to 1960. So arguably, you could sit out and wait for one of those levels to be lost or reclaimed. You know, there's no point in jumping into a trade if you miss the trade off the weekly right now. Just got to be a bit more patient now on gold. I will now bring our focus back over to the ES a second. And obviously, really simply, I'm an ES bull and it's treated me well once again. We were obviously saying that this was a very strong looking market. We did come up into 3,300 points consolidated, you know, consolidation below resistance, and we broke through it this morning. I'm really simply looking for this one to go next to 3,330 points. We could possibly get rejected there. Okay, 333.0 points for me is a very important level. Rejection could see us back test 3290. If no rejection, I fully expect us to hit 3370. Moving into the final star of the show, Bitcoin. So obviously we go through those bigger markets because of the correlation that's happening at the moment with Bitcoin. If you are not tracking those other markets, you are actually trading Bitcoin completely blind. So that's why I've covered that. Now we can look at Bitcoin chart. As we all know from yesterday's video, we were expecting the range to be put in. What have we got here? Absolutely, we've got that. We've got the range. And you see how important or beneficial it is to predict the day type ahead before it's even begun, expecting a range. And that's exactly what we got. Absolutely invaluable information I'm giving you here. So we've obviously got that range. On top of that, ladies and gentlemen, we had the CCV setup. Absolutely perfect. In the end, as you can see, rejecting off of around 10,500 and bringing you down to that target, which was 10,420. Really, really nice. You're obviously now getting your reaction You know, that the bounce off of that. I am in a long position at the moment. Do we make it up any further? Well, arguably, I'm in a little bit of two minds at the moment. Obviously, you do not want to be longing where you are now. You had to have got into longs a little bit lower, let's be honest. But nevertheless, we have still got a potential range going on here, which would bring you back up. Again, the top of the range is still around 10,520. The low of the range is still around 10,340. So a few things to note on the Bitcoin chart, that this has just built another low, higher low, higher low, potentially another higher low. Okay, so you are building higher lows here, with obviously the higher high being put in last night, which I have to shout out to some of the members that were shorting up there. That was brilliant. If you haven't, you need to go back into the chat yesterday at around 9 p.m. because some of the trades that we've done in this section were just absolutely outstanding. I recommend you go back and read through the chat. Yeah, definitely. Basically, we were going long, short, long in this section. Yeah, it was beautiful. Anyway, I don't want to focus too much on that. As we can see, we're seeing a little bit of a rise this morning, highly correlated to the ES rising at the moment. And yeah, I think I would like to see 10,520 test. I've already hit take profit one on this. My take profit two is 10,520. And ultimately, I'm still going to be looking to trade the range. Obviously, if we break up out of this range, I'm really looking at 10,650. If we break down of this range, I'm looking towards 10,200. So really simply, I'm trading the range until it breaks on Bitcoin. And, you know, there's opportunities, really big opportunities today on Ethereum, and for me anyway, on the GC. So that is what I will be focusing on. As always, everybody, I will be around all the time in the chat, you know, from where we are now until like 1 a.m. tonight. So I'll be around all day. Should you have any questions, shout out to the people that were literally shorting the exact high of those moves yesterday. Technical analysis just absolutely going absolutely perfectly, and I hope that you have a brilliant day ahead. I'm thoroughly looking forward to it, and should there be any changes in the analysis during the day, I will update you as always inside of the chat. Cheers, everybody. Thank you. Let's crush it, and goodbye. So that was the contenders and champions members update video that I've just published this morning, and this will be the last one that I put on YouTube, and it's just so you can see the absolute massive value that you are getting within this to not only crush Bitcoin yesterday with the trades I was taking throughout the day, but also correctly predicting the DXY dollar index, ES, S&P 500 futures, and GC, the gold futures, the four biggest markets in the world, all four correctly predicted. That is pretty crazy, let's be honest. So yeah, that is the value that you can be getting, and I'm just more than happy to put this out here, and so you can see what you're missing out on, really. Obviously, this includes as well all of the updates that I give throughout the day, and when I'm in my zone, yeah, it's hard to get ahead of me. As well as, obviously, tonight we have, just so you're aware, another live stream. This is an educational live stream where I will be covering, obviously, the setups that we have going on within this template. So yeah, I just want to upload this onto YouTube, show you again what the members update was like today, and yeah, hope that you have an absolute brilliant day. Thank you, everybody. Goodbye.